Robert Koch Life and Career Part 3, Research. Anthrax. Robert Koch is widely known for his work with anthrax, discovering the causative agent of the fatal disease to be Bacillus anthracis. He discovered the formation of spores in anthrax bacteria, which could remain dormant under specific conditions. However, under optimal conditions, the spores were activated and caused disease. To determine this causative agent, he dry-fixed bacterial cultures onto glass slides, used dyes to stain the cultures, and observed them through a microscope. His work with anthrax is notable in that he was the first to link a specific microorganism with a specific disease, rejecting the idea of spontaneous generation and supporting the germ theory of disease. Tuberculosis. During his time as the government advisor with the Imperial Department of Health in Berlin in the 1880s, Robert Koch became interested in tuberculosis research. At the time, it was widely believed that tuberculosis was an inherited disease. However, Koch was convinced that the disease was caused by a bacterium and was infectious, and tested his four postulates using guinea pigs. Through these experiments, he found that his experiments with tuberculosis satisfied all four of his postulates. In 1882, he published his findings on tuberculosis, in which he reported the causative agent of the disease to be the slow-growing Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Later, Koch's attempt at developing a drug to treat tuberculosis led to a scandalous failure. Cholera. Koch next turned his attention to cholera, and began to conduct research in Egypt in the hopes of isolating the causative agent of the disease. However, he was not able to complete the task before the epidemic in Egypt ended, and subsequently traveled to India to continue with the study. In 1884 in Bombay state of India, Koch resided and researched at Grant Medical College, where he was able to determine the causative agent of cholera, isolating Vibrio cholerae. The bacterium had originally been isolated in 1854 by Italian anatomist Filippo Pacini, but its exact nature and his results were not widely known. Acquired immunity. Koch observed the phenomenon of acquired immunity. On December 26, 1900, he arrived as part of an expedition to German New Guinea, which was then a protectorate of the German Reich. Koch serially examined the Papuan people, the indigenous inhabitants, and their blood samples and noticed they contained Plasmodium parasites, the cause of malaria, but their bouts of malaria were mild or could not even be noticed, that is, were subclinical. On the contrary, German settlers and Chinese workers, who had been brought to New Guinea, fell sick immediately. The longer they had stayed in the country, however, the more they too seemed to develop a resistance against it. Awards and honors. In 1897, Koch was elected a foreign member of the Royal Society, ForMemRS. In 1905, Koch won the Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine for his work with tuberculosis. In 1906, research on tuberculosis and tropical diseases won him the Prussian Order pour le Merite and in 1908, the Robert Koch Medal, established to honor the greatest living physicians. Koch's name is one of 23, from the fields of hygiene and tropical medicine, featured on the frieze of the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine building in Keppel Street, Bloomsbury. A large marble statue of Koch stands in a small park known as Robert Koch Platz, just north of the Charity Hospital, in the Mitte section of Berlin. His life was the subject of a 1939 German-produced motion picture that featured Oscar-winning actor Emil Jannings in the title role. On December 10, 2017, Google showed a doodle in celebration of Robert Koch's birthday.